Hi everybody, Admir with UTS here. Today we're going to talk about the fuel system on the TYM tractors, specifically the 474, 494, 574. Basically, the issues that can arise, proper maintenance, some of the stuff we've seen. What inspired us to do this video today is we have a tractor in the shop right now with 200 hours on it. It was sold less than a year ago, and customer brought it in with some smoking on the engine, some weird things going on. We took a look at the fuel system and we knew immediately that's what the problem was. So let's get into it. The TYM 474, 494, 574. This is a mechanically fuel injected diesel engine, as I'm sure most of you have seen my other videos. The fuel system itself, away from the fuel injection pump, what feeds fuel to the fuel injection pump, is very simple. It's very serviceable by the user, and I love the simplicity of it. These are your two main fuel filters. Sediment bowl, fuel water separator. This one's first in line. This one is second in line. After this, the fuel goes directly into the fuel injection pump. This customer's issue was water in the fuel. A lot of water in the fuel. It had never been drained. It caused this filter inside this bowl to corrode into nothing. We're gonna splice in the photo of it so you can see what it looked like. I even have the fuel saved that came out of the system so you can see how nasty this fuel was. Fuel system maintenance is so important for the longevity of your engine, and it's so easy. Unscrew this, drop down the bowl, stick in a new filter, you're done with this one. This thing isn't, it's a bit of a drawback that it's not serviceable individually and the paper element isn't replaceable, but who cares? It's two bolts, you swap it out, and you're done. Again, this tractor had a problem with water in the fuel. How can you spot water in your fuel? Well, the fuel water separator has a little red ring in it, and we're going to do a close-up of this, and I'm going to show you what it looks like with water in it. But when there is water in this bowl, this red ring will rise. You'll see it floating. Oh my gosh, I see this ring floating. What do I do now? You just turn this. You turn it a couple turns, the water will flow out of it. You can stick a little hose right there so then you can divert the water so it's not getting all over your engine. But it is really, it's daily maintenance. If there's at all a risk of water being in your fuel, every single day, just turn this thing, let a couple drops out and be done with it. This customer had a lot of water in this thing for a long time. This bowl, we ended up replacing the whole assembly just because there was so much junk in here and corrosion that we weren't sure that this plastic itself wasn't breaking down or some weird thing wasn't going on. So we just replaced this whole thing for them. Something to touch on, this is not a warranty item of any kind. This is pure maintenance. The TYM owner's manual says to replace this thing and the filter in here at 500 hours. Now, that's perfect world, right? Where there was never a drop of water that got into this, or this was drained every day. Water is very corrosive when it comes to these fuel systems. So what it did is it ate this filter apart. So this is plain old maintenance, and it was maintenance that was neglected a bit. Now, I can't open it right here. Maybe I can, nope. I'm gonna open this and we'll splice it in later, but a common problem with this fuel system. So when we started making these videos, I told everybody, I tell it how it is. The good things, the bad. This thing has a bit of a, I won't say a design flaw, it's not a design flaw at all, but a common problem is the O-ring that's under this, and we'll take it apart, we'll splice it in, but this O-ring will expand. It's not the best rubber. I actually don't know the reason for it, but it will expand, it will not seal, and this can cause all kinds of issues. One, you can suck air through here. Your engine will lose power, it'll smoke, all kinds of issues. Obviously it can break like any other O-ring. We've also seen some deformations of the actual bowl itself. So this is a super easy part to replace. honestly, lots of even aftermarket options for this thing, but something to keep an eye on, where if this O-ring is bad, this filter's bad, this bowl is warped and you're sucking air, this can be causing problems with your Kukje engine. Now, additives. I'm not gonna get into the world of additives. Everybody has their own opinion on it. My opinion, I think, is very different than most people. I think they're mostly snake oil. If somebody really wants to get into it with me, I'll be at the National Farm Machinery Show, we can talk about it. But I think it's all snake oil. And the most important thing in maintaining your fuel system is maintenance and getting quality diesel. Now, diesel has summer blend, winter blend, tons of information on the internet about this. I'm not gonna go too far into it. But if you're in the northern states, you're getting a winter blend. You wanna make sure that that's what you're using come winter time, that you're not using buckets that are from the summer. And clean diesel, not stored in open buckets, nowhere where condensation can get into the tank and then goes into your fuel. That along with replacing these things when they're due and just keeping an eye on them, will pay dividends in the longevity of your engine and maintaining your investment. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you found this informative. Comment, like us, hopefully, drop us a message. Thanks again.